How to make an epic Discord server in 2025. So the first thing you want to do is pick a theme. It can be basic, something that has to do with the server's purpose, or you can get pretty creative with it. This will help you come up with cool names for the roles, categories, or channels. You can pause the video here for inspiration. And now you're ready to click Add a Server. You can start from a template or just create your own. You want to start with a personal server. When it grows, you'll be able to switch to a community one. Upload a picture and name it. Congrats, you have a fresh new server. First thing I like to do is create the roles. Go to Server Settings, and under Roles, you can create all of your roles. What I advise you to do is actually do not give any permissions yet to your roles until you know exactly what they do. The things that you need to remember is that the role order matters. So in a basic server, the people with the least amount of permissions should be at the bottom, and the people, or the bots, with the most should be all the way up top. I always create a bot role that I can assign to all my bots. That way I can easily manage them and display them on the side. Once you have your roles, you should create categories. Those will help you organize your channels, but also manage the roles a little bit easier. For example, under a welcome category, you can display the roles. You can show a list of the newcomers and have your announcement channel. A quick tip is to display what each role means. Another quick tip is to use emojis in front of your categories so that they're easily identifiable. You can do the same thing for your channels, but also make sure that you test them in multiple platforms because sometimes, as you can see, they do not show up. Here's an example of a server where most of them show up. Most of them. Now, before you start populating your categories with voice or text channels, you can already edit the general permissions. For example, in your information category, you know that you don't want anyone to be able to send messages except for your mods. So you make sure that everyone cannot send messages in this whole category except for your mods. Then you want to do the same with the rest of your categories. If you don't do that, you would have to go channel by channel, setting up specific permissions. A quick tip is to set up an AFK voice channel, and you can assign it in your server settings. Under inactive channel, you just select your AFK one. Now, if someone is not speaking for 5 minutes, let's say that they fall asleep, they'll be sent to this channel. Remember to save changes. For your announcement channels, if you ever want to do fancy embeds like that, you need to use something called Disco Hook. It basically allows you to make posts like this, which makes it look more official. Now, when it comes to bots, there's a whole lot of choices. Mi6 is probably the most popular one. It allows you to do a bunch of stuff, including keeping a leaderboard for the most active members of your server. So the more they participate, the more XP they gain. So it might encourage your members to be more active. It also does moderation and social media alerts. Free Stuff Bot is also one that I really like, because it'll send a message in a specific channel telling you which games are currently free or free to play. And it does that for multiple platforms. Poke2 is an interesting one, and it basically allows your users to play a text-based Pokemon game. CoralBot is also pretty popular. I believe it's mostly used for the reaction roles, so people who join your server can click on a specific reaction to get a role. But when it comes to which bot is perfect for your server, you want to do some research because a lot of them end up doing the exact same thing. The only annoying thing is that some of them will make you pay for extra features, so that's why most people will have a collection of multiple bots to accomplish everything for free. Now that you have your bots, your channels, your categories, you want to think about adding some custom emojis. If you're not an emoji artist, you can go to emoji.gg or discadia.com in order to get the basics. Quick reminder that Discord is a degenerate place, so a lot of emojis are going to be inappropriate or 18 plus on those websites. So you would want to save those emojis to your computer, and to add them, you go to server settings, and right there under roles, you'll find emoji. Something else that you might want to populate in your server is the soundboard. Yes, Discord has a soundboard option for when you're in voice chat. You'll find it at the bottom left, and your members will be able to use them. Now, there's a billion places to find sound effects online, but I like using tuna.voicemod.net. The sounds are uploaded by the users, so you can find any meme, music, sound effects from video games that you can think of.
You are clear to engage.
And it's super easy to download. Just click download. And boom, you can download it. And you're pretty much ready to invite people. Some extra tips to keep it interesting. Try running giveaways. Something we see happen a lot is people will join a server and then mute the server right away. Giveaways will give them a reason to check on the server from time to time. You also want to run events. Now, it doesn't always have to be an active event. For example, I like to set events for new game releases, new movies, new TV shows. I basically like to use it as some sort of reminder. It keeps the server interesting. But of course, you want to run actual events like watch parties, game nights, live streams, anything. Another tip to keep people active is to encourage them to share their day-to-day life. So having channels where they can share their food, pictures of their pets is a great incentive. All in all, the best way to have people be active in your server is for you to be active in that server. Managing a Discord server is not easy and it's pretty time consuming. So start small and progressively grow it. If you want a step-by-step guide on how to create a server from scratch, or if you need some templates, I have a couple videos on that subject. I also have a step-by-step guide on how to set up roles. So check that out too. Make sure you subscribe and I'll see you later.